Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, operating system is the hardware synchronization. So you know about the process synchronization, means software synchronization, not process synchronization. Let's talk about the software synchronization. Software synchronization means you are synchronizing the software so that you are going to execute properly. Whenever the user is giving the input, it is responding to that and gives the output. Okay, immediately. So here, then what about the hardware synchronization? Not only the software has to be synchronized, so to work properly, the hardware system is also has to be synchronized. Both the software and the hardware both should be synchronized properly, then only our systems will work efficiently. So let's have a look on this hardware synchronization. Many systems provides a hardware support for critical section code. Let's talk about this critical section code. So you know that the critical section code, that means it is a code where whenever one process is executing in the critical section code, no other process will enter into that stage. After the completion of this section code, another process will end. Suppose P1 is executing, P2 has to wait until P1 is completed in the critical section code. Whenever P1 is completed, it comes out and P2 will enter into the critical section code. So this is a critical section code. So we know that so to work like this properly, we require the hardware support also. Many systems provide hardware support for this critical section code. So let's first have a look on what is this hardware support. I said many system provides hardware supports. Let's take a uniprocessor system. I'm taking one of the system as a uniprocessor. So in uniprocessor, how this hardware support will be working? Uniprocessor system is there, means my system is having only one processor. So how this my system, my laptop or whatever it may be, whatever the gadget I'm using, which is having only uniprocessor, so in that how the hardware support is there? So the uniprocessor provides the hardware support for critical section code. I'm talking about the critical section code. So how it is going to do hardware support whenever the data is entered in the critical section code? So first it is doing, it could disable the interrupts. Whatever the interrupts are there, means the P2 is there, P2, P3, P4 or everything on the queue, and P1 is executing in this critical section code. So first what is my hardware support is doing? It is completely disabling all these interrupts. These are interrupts only because whenever my P1 is executing here, the P2 is entering, disturbing it, P3 is disturbing it, P4 is also disturbing it. So it disturbing the processor to stop the instruction and execute my instruction. So to avoid that, it's simply disabling the interrupts. My hardware, what is my hardware is doing? It disable the interrupt. Then currently running code would execute without preemption. So now my P1, whenever I disable the interrupt, my P1 is calmly currently running its execute without preemption, okay, without any interrupts, and without any priority interrupts will not disturb my process. So it will complete my P1 process will be completing its work and exit the critical section. Whenever it exits the critical section code, then another process will enter into the critical section code. So here what my hardware support will do, it first disables the interrupt. Whenever it disables the interrupt, the P1 can currently running code would execute without preemption. Generally, too inefficient in multiprocessor system, actually this concept, whatever I'm using, the hardware support is there for the critical section, just now I said. So generally this is too inefficient on multiprocessor system. So if it is uniprocessor, means it's okay, but if you're talking about the multiprocessor system, disabling the interrupts, running the current code, it's not possible, because operating system using this not broadly scalable. So let's take the modern machine. So whatever the modern machines we are using, the modern machines provides a special atomic hardware instructions. So here my modern machines, because it is having a multiprocessor system, so will also be there in my modern systems. So it is providing one special atomic hardware instruction. So to support my hardware, okay, to provide hardware support for critical section, my modern machines provide a special atomic hardware instructions. Atomic means that instruction has to be executed without interrupts. my instruction has to be, my process P1 has to be executed without interrupt. So that is the meaning of atomic. Atomic means non-interruptible. It is not interrupting anyone. So these modern machines provides a special atomic hardware instruction that is atomic. So we call it as a non-interruptible. And also it does some codings like test memory word and set value, test and set, and swap content of two memory words, swap. So with the help of these functions, my modern machines provides, okay, specially atomic hardware instructions. So these are my hardware instructions, test and set and swap. So with the help of these hardware instructions, my hardware is going to be synchronized, okay, and maintaining the critical section code. So the hardware support for critical section code is these, test and set and swap. So these are the two hardware instructions. These are the two atomic hardware instructions, okay? So which are support for the critical section code. Do you understand what exactly the hardware synchronization is? If one operation has to be executed, my critical section code has to be executed without interrupts, means my atomic instruction, that is my atomic instruction, that is non-interruptible instruction, has to be executed without any disturbance, means there should be hardware support is also required. So for hardware support, it should be synchronized with the critical section. How it is going to be synchronized? So with the help of some atomic hardware instructions. So what are those hardware instructions? Test and set and swap. Let's look on this test and set. Actually, my test and set instruction is defined as boolean value, okay, either 0 or 1. So test and set, test 0 and set 1. Boolean, it's my target, okay, my process that has to be executed. So I am assigning the pointer target to RV value. So whenever my target pointer is true, okay, I have to return that, I have to enter into the critical section that has to be executed. So this is my atomic value. So this instruction is atomic, and this instruction is provided by the hardware. So this complete in this instruction now will be provided with the hardware. Now this has to be synchronized. How I am going to be synchronized? The solution for this test and set is shared boolean variables are there, because the boolean variables has to be shared by all the processor. The different process wants to enter into the critical section. The shared boolean variable, I am taking it as a lock. So whenever the variable is lock, it is initialized to false. Means here one of process is enter into the critical section, that is atomic instruction enter into the critical section, so it should be locked and it is initialized to false so that the other instructions will not enter into the section. So this solution for the mutual exclusion is do. So first, while the test and set, this is my hardware instruction, the test and set is lock. Whenever it is lock, it is a busy waiting. Okay, it is busy waiting. So means something is entered into the critical section. Whenever something is entered into the critical section, the test and set will not do anything. Okay, it's set enter into the critical section. Okay, and lock false. Whenever the critical section is over, the operation is over, it releases the lock and remainder the section. It works with the remainder section. Okay, and while true. So this is a solution for the test and set hardware instructions for synchronization. To maintain the synchronization, so this is the concept you have to be followed. So let's take the another instruction, that is a swap instruction. I said that another hardware instruction is a swap instruction. So what this swap instruction will do? So this is my basic definition of the swap. Void swap, boolean values, I'm taking two boolean values. So now I'm doing the swapping. So A has to be pointed to the temp variable. Now my temp contains A, and that A name should be moved to the B. Okay, so this is also my atomic instruction. So this instruction is provided by hardware. These instructions will be provided by hardware. Now let's have a look. Solution using swap. The shared Boolean variables lock initialize it to false. So just like a whatever the test end said, we had seen that. So here also for the swap also, you have to do shared Boolean variable lock initialize. You have to maintain a lock and you have to initialize to false. Now each process has a local variable, local Boolean variable. Let's take a key. A key will be there. Now let's have a look on the solution for this mutual execution. First, a key value, I make it as a true. So whenever the key value is true, okay, I'm doing on the swap instructions, my hardware instruction swap. So here I'm making key is equal to true. Whenever my key is equal to true, busy waiting means something is entered into the critical section. So whenever that is there, so I have to exchange swap and lock and key. So these two variables has to be swapped and enter into the critical section. So it is doing the operation. So whenever it is entering into the critical section, after releasing that, the lock has to be put false, and then after that it has to do the remainder section, and this is a do while. It has to be repeat for all the process. So this is about the hardware synchronization. Thank you.